जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम। हेलो सब सुनने वाले देखने वाले, दिस इज आवर लाइव सेशन विद वंडरफुल ज्यूरी ऑफ 12th लाहौर इंटरनेशनल चिल्ड्रंस फिल्म फेस्टिवल। आई एम रियली एक्साइटेड दैट वी हैव सम ऑफ द सिलेक्टेड मेंबर्स हु वर पार्ट ऑफ द ज्यूरी दिस ईयर आर लाइव विद अस टू शेयर सम ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट दे हैव सीन इन फिल्म्स, और जो उन्होंने देखा और जो उन्होंने फिल्म की सिलेक्शन के दौरान जो हो रहा है विल बी एबल टू शेयर सम बिट्स ऑफ दैट। आई विल ब्रीफली जस्ट से अ शाउट आउट नेम। वी हैव विद अस रहीन फातिमा। हाय रहीन, रमीन आसिम, फैजान सरमद और फिलिप जाओ। सो फैजान, रहीम एंड रमीन आर फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान एंड फिलिप हैज जॉइंड अस फ्रॉम फिलीपींस। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर द वंडरफुल कंट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ योर्स टू वर्ड्स द फेस्टिवल एंड बीइंग अ ज्यूरी। सो माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू विल बी ब्रीफली इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ, एनीथिंग दैट इज एक्साइटिंग एंड इंटरेस्टिंग टू नो। Any interest that you have particular and the reason for joining the jury, and then we will start our conversation. Rahim, can you briefly introduce yourself?
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, good. So my name is Shaheen Fatma. I am 12 currently, but the day after tomorrow I have my birthday, so I'm almost 13. I am a stand-up
Hey.
comedian. I am a writer, an entrepreneur, a teacher, a theater actress, an international speaker, and I recently also won the award for the 25 under 25 by the Little Art Organization. I was like, wonderful. I think that was a good thing to share. And my interest in films was like, I think it comes through my grandparents because my grandpa used to like travel 25 miles just to watch the film in the cinema. I mean, he has all these black and white Shabnam and all those big heroes back then, all those films, and I've also watched those. So I think that's where the interest for all the films come from, and I've watched like so many films. So I was like, oh my
Lovely.
God, I finally get to be part of the jury and watch films.
Wonderful. Thank you very much for sharing that introduction, Ka. Ramin, can I ask you to introduce yourself and also give us a bit of a story?
So I'm Ramin Asim, and I'm basically major part of me that I love art, all type arts like films, drawing, painting, everything pretty much. I have a YouTube channel. I just started it like a month ago. And basically on art, and I do speeches. I have been a part of this festival last year, and I was in the jury, but I the film in my school. We'd win, but it was a good experience though. And yeah, pretty much I have participated in different programs. International programs, national programs, between schools and countries. Yep, that's it.
Lovely. Thank you very much, Ramin. Philip.
Hello. Hi.
Yes.
So I'm Philip Cataros from the Philippines. I am a currently in grade 12 in Philippine High School for the Arts, theater arts student. So I'm experienced in, directing, acting, dramaturgy, and all those theater stuff. So I really enjoyed being being soaked in this film world since I'm from this theater. So yes, yeah, it's a very new and interesting experience for me.
Wonderful. Thank you very much for joining us, Philip. Faizan.
My name is Faizan Sarmad and I'm from Pakistan. I'm 13 years old and my hobby is photography and video making. So basically when I was I was a young jury. It was really exciting experience, and I was shocked at first because I was going to do this for the first time in my life. But it was really great, and it was a really brand new experience. That's it.
Wonderful. Thank you very much for your introduction and sharing a bit about yourself and the wonderful story. I now have some questions, and we will talk about certain things about the festival and your experience with the jury. Only one thing is that you can speak in English or you can आप उर्दू में बात करें any language that you are comfortable with कोई भी ज़ुबान बोलें जिसमें आप बोल सकते हैं and I'll try to translate it for Philip also and ताकि हमारी जो पाकिस्तान में audience है उनको भी सबसे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा समझ आए so my first question to Ramin is that कैसा रहा experience jury का how was it you were selected and then you also saw some of the films so festival mein jo aapne films dekhi if you can share a bit about it also ji Raheen maybe you can take the question and then we will come to Ramin later
yes so first like after the selection and like I was told that I would have to watch the films and honestly I was like really excited because the films and again the films do not come from one specific area in the world like they some are from France and some are from you know different even villages based in different villages in Africa so there's you know very you know you have versatility in all the films and different cultures are kind of brought together I already have a favorite though. I mean like I had a hard time picking the films because you know I'd watch a film and I'd be like this is probably my favorite. And then I watch the other one I'm like no, I mean this is my second favorite. So you know after that a lot of hard work I had to put in for that but amazing films, you know, well-written scripts and I feel like acting is good. But a good director is really, really needed for good acting because I've done theater and I'm the kind of a person who's the director's actor or something. I don't know. That's, I think, what you call it. But it's always like I need a director to guide me what to do. And those films, you could see the director's work and also the actors kind of, you know, carrying it all out. The writers, everything. So it was like amazing films. And the jury, you know, me being this very big time film watcher, being part of the jury was like probably the biggest achievement of my film watching life.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Raheen. And sorry to put you in a situation where you were seeing so many wonderful films and you had to make difficult decisions. But that's the part, that's the job the jury has. Bahut shukriya. Thank you very much. Fizan, can I ask you, how was your experience being part of the jury this year?
My experience was really great, but of all the films that I watched, it was really hard to decide. All were so good. And so well made, and they were all from different regions of the world, different cultures and different places. It was a refreshing and new experience. It was very hard to decide a new one, a really good one.
Wonderful. So you enjoyed because all the films are from different countries. So we have 58 films from 28 countries, I think, in 16 languages this year in the festival. So, yes, you picked it right that the diversity of the festival is really, really interesting.
Yes.
So once you see more films, you will also feel that, you know, this is kind of itself is an experience to watch the film, let's decide the story. Wonderful. Thank you, Fizan. Philip, can I ask you the same
yes.
question?
Hi. So like what I said earlier, this is a very interesting and new experience for me. It's also refreshing to witness various films that, you know, were created to be celebrated, to be shared, especially for children. And As a theater arts student, I further understood how potent this medium is to, you know, a lot of people in various backgrounds. And as most people are still in lockdown, you know, right now you would just say, it's no longer you are what you eat, you are what you watch. And so, yeah, I'm very thankful to be part of this and, you know, to be able to witness these passionate and heartwarming films. It's just, yes, wonderful.
Lovely. Thank you. Thank you very much. Ramin?
So this experience was a really good one for me. I usually watch a lot of films, like at least one in a day. And I understood how judges make these tough decisions. Like, all of these films were great. And I had to make the decision of rating them. And it was really tough. And I understood, like, I did not have the grudges to rate them. I literally did not. I felt so bad being like, okay, this is the best one, but this is a little, this doesn't have subtitles or something like that. I felt bad doing that, but then I was like, I have a duty and I have to do that. So it was a really good experience.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. And what was the film that you kind of liked the most? And it might be a film, or it might be a character, or it might be a situation, anything that you like the most, and you can share that experience and why kind of you liked it. Raheen?
So I loved the film, a short film, Machine Poor. So, like, it was so good. And it was basically it was like what one of, like, my main goals is that to teach people that they have to realize their true potential and unlock it. So it was like literally like unlocking it. So it was like amazing. And my favorite character, of course, was the lead. It was Circuit. And like when he was born, he was also called Short Circuit. But yeah, Circuit was like my favorite. I love that film. But of course, you know, there were other films that were also my favorites along the entire process that I had of the day to watch all the films. But at the end, I was like, okay, Machine Poor it is.
Lovely. Thank you very much. I'm glad you liked it. I think it's a film from Pakistan. So lovely. Faizan.
My favorite film was Harbe. And it was so sad, and my favorite character was the teacher, the boy in the film. He was a poor boy, and the teacher brought him with the whole school, so he could restart a new life, and it was really emotional.
So you liked the story because it was about you know, emotions, and then possibly also the generation difference, but also similarity.
Yes.
Wonderful. Ramin, can I come to you now with the same question? What was your favorite film, and what did you like the most in it?
I liked Baku and the Giants. I think it was a really good film. It actually taught us about, you know, saving the animals and stuff, the endangered species. It was a really good film. And the fact that her mother was drunk all the time, I actually felt like people have mothers like this, and she doesn't pretty much care about her children. She's always going out drinking and stuff, and then she comes, the children have to drag her home while she's drunk. So I was like, I was shocked to see that, but otherwise the film was great. I really loved the girl, basically, because she felt the pain for the rhinos. Like, wow, we have very rare people who actually care about animals. So that was a good one.
Since you are talking about it, I really liked the very powerful visuals also. The way she is standing in front of a rhino with her hand on
yes, it was good.
Its head. It looked and it was so such a
real.
powerful image. Yeah. Sorry, go ahead. You were saying something.
It looked so real, like the place and the rhino. I don't think it was real, of course. It was effects and stuff, animation. But her dressing when she was in front of the rhino, it actually looked like a tribal person from the old tribes and stuff. It was cool.
Thank you very much, Ramin. So what worked for you, Philip? How was your experience with any film?
For me, that would be it's also Harbor. So I generally love the ambiguity of it. You know, like the especially the silences, the parts where there were no dialogue, and just moments of waiting. And as an audience, you don't really understand what those silences were for, but you feel this dynamics of tension, and you know it's loosening, there's intensifying tension, and which were even amplified by the intimacy of the shots. It's really good. And the whole piece has this recurring idea of secrecy, you know, like each character were motivated by their own secrets, their hidden objectives, and we as audience were not given the opportunity to know those objectives since, you know, we're only given to this really short time to see them. So we don't know where they come from or what who they are, and what will they be when they reach London, you know. And it's really a wonderful feeling, and we yeah.
Lovely. Thank you very much for saying that. And I think talking about the spaces that filmmakers have left in the film to engage you as an audience is kind of really interesting to find and kind of be engaged with that. So if I may ask, what these films, maybe the film that you just mentioned or any of the films that you see, what did it made you feel? And I'm asking this question because, one, what did it make you feel? But also, what did you really learn out of it? Because telling a story or liking a character is one thing, but when you feel something, that's kind of where, you know, people are moved with cinema as an audience. Or what was your bigger message that you possibly get from any film? If we can start with Ramin now.
So again, Bahu and the Giants, I actually love animals, like cats, dogs, like the pets basically. But I've never been close to wild animals. But I still like them, like I really care. Like in my house, my grandparents don't actually like animals. They're allergic and stuff like that. So I'm always convincing them that I want a pet, but they don't let me. So when I watch this, I related to it kind of because in Bahu and the Giants, they were pretty much just killing the dinosaur. I'm sorry, the dinosaur, the rhino. And
I know.
my grandfather doesn't like dogs, so or cats. So whenever a stray cat or a dog is crossing by the road, he actually wants it to run. So he scares them away. And I always try to stop him, but I just I can't actually say something to him loud enough or because he just won't understand. He's like, they're not good. They're stray animals and stuff. But whenever I get a chance, I actually feed them, like give milk to the cat or give her some chicken or something like that. So that was really relatable to me. It was, that's why it's my favorite film out of all of these.
Lovely. So there's an experience of yours, and you were able to relate that because you also like few things related to animal and the whole life that is beyond us in this on this earth. Thank you very much, Philip.
What I felt about this film.
What was the so I'll ask the question again briefly. What was how did you feel watching any particular film, or what was the key message that you got out of it?
there's this feeling of, you know, after watching actually everything, there's this feeling of longing, like something has been, you know, part of you that you really want to fill in. And because, you know, you're just there sitting and watching everything and like, what's next? And it's an interesting experience that, you know, what are you really gonna do? Should you, you know, jump around to feel that longing? And yeah, that was what I felt throughout the whole binge watching.
Lovely. Raheen.
So interestingly, I am like a big time watching film crier. Like I sometimes wouldn't cry on situations that people would actually expect me to cry, but I would, cry my eyes out while watching a film, just because it's just that feeling inside you that, maybe it's like kind of being there and experiencing it. So while watching Baku and the Giants, Harbor, and also another film, I cannot recall the name though, but those three films, I was like literally crying because of that feeling inside me that was just up, like, you know, how also of like how the storyline went, of course, but also because of the fact that how film was such a powerful medium of conveying a specific message. And I was also happy that the filmmaker was, at least to me, was able to convey that message that he wanted or she wanted to convey. So yeah, I was happy and sad, yeah.
Wonderful, beautifully said, I think. Thank you very much for sharing that. Faizan, I'll come to you with the same question. What was your feeling and what was the kind of the key thing that you got out of it?
Watching every film had a different experience. Some were sad and some were happy, but above all the films had different emotions, and it was a really great experience to watch all of the films, and I was really curious that what the next one was going to be.
So there was an element of surprise and also a bit of longing. All right, wonderful. Thank you very much. I'm really, really kind of happy and excited after listening your profound analysis and talking about feelings. Thank you very much for doing that. I have the last question. And for our audience who is listening to us, the festival is online now, and it is, I mean, unfortunately, it's only for the audiences who are in Pakistan because of our limited rights and management. So all the audiences who are listening in Pakistan, sare bache, young log, families, jinko ye film dekhni hai, wo StarsPlay pe ye dekh sakte hain, aur hamara jo website hai festival ki, lahorechildrensfilm.com. You can come there and also register, and we will be sending all the details that you need to see films and be engaged in workshops and online sessions that we will be doing this month and next month. Perfect. Thank you. So my last question to you is, what is your message to all the young people who possibly are listening so they can be kind of motivated to see and find a reason to see these films? Why you should be watching more films of the festival, and then why other young people who are listening to us should be seeing the festival as well online? Raheen.
So I think films are really powerful when, a film is something that you could really use when conveying a powerful message. And also that our audience needs to be acceptive, every individual as individuals, and also young individuals, we should be acceptive And we should actually try to make ourselves more acceptive of things, whether that be messages that are tried to be conveyed to us, and know what you have to be acceptive of and what not. So you could actually pick up a message from, you know, those blockbuster Indian films, or pick a message from maybe a film that is like 5 minutes and it's supposed to show you how orphans struggle, and then that would make you care more that you have parents and you should embrace them and also help those who do not have parents. Now you could pick up messages from anything. Now it's your choice to pick up positive messages and also embrace the art of film, because film too is a medium to express yourself, and that's literally the definition of art.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Raheen. Faizan, kyun dekhna chahiye baki young logon ko bhi film festival, aur film festival mein sari jo films hain, so Lahore International Children's Film Festival ke jo program mein films hain, why all young people should attend the festival online?
All young people should see the films because they all are great and they all convey a powerful message. They can take it in positively, and all the films are really great, and it expresses, all the film express a different opinion or a different message. So that's why.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. Ramin, what is your message?
I think people, like all the, either it's adults or children, they should watch these films, because I think you can learn a single thing from anything. Either it's a film, it's a book. You pick up at least one thing from a book or a film, or even your mistakes. You learn from your mistakes, or you learn from your success as well. You learn from everything. Either it's a positive thing or a negative thing. So these films, I've watched them, and each one has a message. Each film. And all of them are just brilliant. Like, every little thing about each film is just great. And I think our youth should learn new things to actually grow. We can't do anything till we learn stuff from our mistakes or from... You should learn something when you get a chance. If you have a chance, like I had the chance of joining this festival and being a part of the jury. So I actually had the opportunity, and I did it because I wanted to learn something new, and I did. So you should watch them. All of them are interesting, and they just teach you a great lesson. And films are great anyway. Everybody loves them. So why won't you watch it?
Thank you very much. Bahut shukriya. Philip, what is your message?
Hopefully everyone could watch these films, as they were made beautifully with passion and hard work. And it's really apparent in these films, which I think deserve, these films deserve to be, you know, seen and shared, to be to, you know, invoke exchanges in discourse, you know, and some of these films are very timely. It really reflects the current situations, you know, and yeah, it's a wild roller coaster ride if you watch these. So please do. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, and for all of your wonderful thoughts and sharing kind of a deep understanding about film as a form, and also speaking about certain films that you watch as part of T12's Lahore International Children's Film Festival. I am thankful to you for joining us today, but also thankful to you to be part of the jury. And I would like to mention that there are we have 178 jury members in all different age groups. So I am thankful to all the jury members. Because of course we can't bring everybody online for a session, which would be very, very challenging. but I would like to possibly do that some at some point, maybe not this year, but next year. It's great. So my thanks to all the young jury members who have voted and who are seeing films, and also who is promoting films and promoting the festival to our other peers and students, friends. Bahut shukriya. On this note, I think I will take a note of thanks also from all the team from Little Ard, who has been working on this festival for the past almost a year to put it together, even during Corona times, and we thought we will be doing it in a way that is still possible. And thank you very much for being part of our journey. And we will be in touch. Thank you and khuda hafiz. Bye.